Dr. Jandrisik recently published a very helpful report called The Status of Thrips Control in Canadian Greenhouses. I liked it so much that I decided to use it to talk about the subject matter in more detail. Certainly true for North America in general, the 1990s saw a tempestuous use of various products for thrips control, which can be typified in the word all, including both chemical insecticides and biocontrol agents like Amblyopsis swirskii. Today, there is a much more succinct plan of action, and biocontrols are a very integral aspect therein. According to a Vineland Research and Innovation Center survey, they're still the number one crop pest due to their constant presence, requiring constant controls, which are both costly and complicated to maintain. Although biocontrol agents are more ecologically friendly, they do not often match the immediacy that chemical applications have on the target, thrips included, and require preventative actions to achieve the best efficacy on encroaching populations. A third of the thrips populations identified in Ontario were Thrips tabaci, the onion thrips, and the other two-thirds were Franklinella occidentalis, the western flower thrips. Both species comprise a large part of a relatively small number of pestiferous thrips species, so it isn't surprising that this is a demographic. However, less common species can be more resistant to biocontrol agents and other aspects of an integrated pest management program that does not account for them, making identification an important part of crop scouting. Certothrips dorsalis, the chili thrips, can be found in many locations in the United States of America, representing a biosecurity risk to Canadian greenhouse cultivation. According to Dr. Jandrisik, the damage can be very intense and resemble the damage of broad mites. Appropriate to their name, they have red-colored ocelli, or simple eyes, that exist in between their compound eyes and above the space colored green in this diagram, known as the pronatum. Red ocelli are not unique to chili thrips, and are also present in western flower thrips, making the conformation of other characteristics important, like the size and the length of certain hairs that are attached to the pronatum. The thrips demographics from the previous survey also varied between crops, sometimes dramatically. Geography plays a large role in pest pressure dynamics, as certain places may have more or less of an established species, and certain places may be more likely to grow one crop over another for a variety of environmental or economic reasons, which additionally may or may not be more susceptible to certain pest species. Western flower thrips were the most dominant thrip species encountered, except with Gerbera and Mandevilla. Seasonal changes also affect populations, both outside and inside the greenhouse. Hotter summer months tend to see larger populations, and so preventative measures can be deployed in anticipation of these more intense time periods to mitigate production damage, such as the control of unnecessary plant life which may harbor the thrips nearby, the use of screens, and an increase in biocontrol agent application. As things move forward, biocontrol measures that are more broadly effective against the less common thrip species develops, such as with the entomopathogenic fungi like Buveria bassiana. Research is currently ongoing to help impair the establishment of chili thrips into Canada.